Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and you're watching iPhoneTopics.com. Many people complained a lot that they bought a new MacBook Pro M1 and they struggled with the Wi-Fi issues also. They also said that the Wi-Fi is unstable and that's troubling people a lot. I searched for the solutions and found some. I'll say what it is in this video. Let's get started. Solution number 1. Reboot your Mac. Guys, since it is a network related issue, you can try rebooting your Mac and that will solve your problem. I am recommending this as a first solution because many people have said that this solution has worked for them, so you can also give it a try. For that, go to the Apple menu on the top left corner of the screen. In the drop down menu, hit the restart option. After that, your Mac will be restarted within a few minutes. And then, now check whether your Wi-Fi signal strength is better or not. That's it. Solution number 2, check for the software updates. We usually recommend these software updates because we know that the various new upcoming software updates will not always create us a problem. Sometimes it fixes the bugs and other issues in the Mac. So you can try it out. For that, go to the Apple menu and click System Preferences. You can see the software update option. Just give a click. And now it's checking for updates. Once after it is checked, click on the Upgrade Now option to update to the latest version. Okay? That's it. Solution number 3, update date, time and location on your Mac. I know guys, this sounds awkward to you. You'll think, what's the connection between the date, time and Wi-Fi? But sometimes when the date, time is wrong in your Mac, that will lead to other problems including Wi-Fi. Okay? So what you have to do is, just click on the Apple logo and select System Preferences. In that you have to tap date and time. Select the time zone tab. Now set the correct time automatically according to the current location. It's also necessary that you have given a correct location or not. Okay. So guys, additionally, I'll give you a suggestion that is nothing but try to remove the unwanted accessories from your Mac because sometimes these extra peripheral devices create as a problem. Once you finish the work, you can remove the unwanted accessories, though it may be a mouse or keyboard. If it is unused, you can remove it. Okay. So guys, I think this simple video has helped you a lot. If you have any friend who is struggling with the same problem, then share this video with him. And if you know any other solutions to solve this issue, you can mention it in the comments because we'll pin the worked solutions at the top. And if you like this video, then like, share and subscribe to iPhoneTopics.com and tap on the bell icon so that you'll be notified when we post a new video. Bye-bye.